Can you predict how a disease that occurred during the science and technology deprived impoverished times of the Middle Ages would affect people? The Black Death was one of the most terrifying disasters in human history. The grim face of death engulfed every corner of Europe. Doctors wearing black robes wandered helplessly amid the cries of patients. The symptoms of the plague were terrifying and horrifying: fever, trembling, headache, swelling of lymph nodes, and purple patches on the skin. Sometimes death would come a few hours after infection, while other times it would torment for days. The Black Death turned people's lives upside down. Families, friends, and neighbors disappeared one by one. Churches, cemeteries, and streets were filled to the brim with corpses. No one knew the reason behind it. Some believed they were being punished by God's wrath, while others sought to blame witches, Jews, or foreigners. The Black Death cast a dark shadow over humanity. But at the same time, it heralded a new beginning. Those who survived the plague began to see life with a different perspective. There were new developments in the fields of science, art, and culture. The seeds of the Renaissance were sown. The Black Death was both an end and a beginning. During this three-year-long epidemic, millions of people lost their lives. Now let's take a brief journey to that dark period and witness the dimensions of the suffering that took place. The Black Death derived its name from the formation of black spots on the skin. The epidemic first emerged in the port of Genoa, Italy, in 1347 and quickly spread to other regions of Europe. It spread from the Mediterranean basin to Constantinople, Sicily, and the Italian peninsula, reaching Africa, Western Asia, and the rest of Europe. In densely populated areas where people interacted extensively, especially in markets, it was more easily transmitted. The disease caused a great catastrophe in Europe, leaving people in fear, panic, and horror. This epidemic could not only infect humans, but also domestic animals. Therefore, in some cities, dogs and cats were also killed. Due to the lack of reliable sources, we cannot be completely certain, but it is estimated that the Black Death killed between 30% to 60% of the European population between 1347 and 1351. Regardless of the exact number of deaths, this significant population loss had profound economic consequences, both for humans and animals. Cities affected by the plague were doomed to economic contraction due to a decrease in production capacity or a decrease in demand for goods and services. As the number of workers decreased due to deaths, the remaining ones began to demand higher wages. Among the reasons for the rapid spread of the epidemic were insufficient hygiene practices, extensive human travel, and the presence of diseased animals. The plague was transmitted through fleas carrying a bacterium called Yersinia pestis. After feeding on infected rats, these fleas would pass the disease to humans. Everything was conducive to the easy spread of the Black Death. The disease manifested itself with symptoms such as fever, trembling, headache, muscle aches, and, in the final stage, black sores on the skin, creating great terror and even societal hysteria. People were gripped by fear and chaos, and deaths were relentlessly increasing. Funeral ceremonies had become meaningless, with dead bodies being left to decay in the streets, and people struggled to cremate the corpses. The fear and chaos caused by the plague, coupled with the insufficient medical knowledge about how it spread, led to acts of violence. Jews and other religious and ethnic minorities were sometimes accused of causing and spreading the plague, becoming targets of attacks. The crucial point, however, is that the plague facilitated the growth of existing tensions and their transformation into acts of violence, rather than solely causing social tension. During this period, people began hiding in their homes to prevent deaths, taking special precautions to bury the dead, and implementing various methods to end the outbreak. Moreover, the fear of death had caused a significant crisis of religious beliefs. The efforts of people to cling to life had radically changed their daily lives. The outbreak caused a major setback in agriculture and trade, leaving long-lasting effects on the European economy. The most important information about the Black Death is that the extensive interconnected trade networks existing at the time enabled the spread of the plague and significantly altered the affected local communities. Aside from its devastating consequences, the Black Death outbreak led to increased awareness of hygiene and stricter adherence to health rules. Its impact was so significant that whenever similar outbreaks occurred in different periods of history, each disease was compared to the Black Death. Despite the pain and suffering, the Black Death epidemic also led to significant advancements in medicine and public health. Following the Black Death, measures for hygiene and epidemic control increased, and new precautions were taken to prevent the spread of such diseases. Although the Black Death outbreak deeply affected people's lives, societies became more resilient by learning from this dark period. The epidemic, along with population decline and the disruption of economic balances, also brought about social and cultural changes. During this period, Black and Death themes gained prominence in art and literature, creating a somber atmosphere. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoyed this video. As always, remember that our learning journey is never ending, and we'll continue to explore new knowledge together. Until next time.